And interestingly, even if you're taking up AI, it's not going to exactly, you know, completely overlap. The AI algorithms defined in computer networks are specifically tailored for the task. Okay? So we have two algorithms here, and the algorithms will be used by the protocols as well. Okay? So that's a plan. Top-down approach, and if you're talking to some of your friends who are doing engineering, okay, they will say, oh, have you started with the physical layer? No, we're starting with the application layer. This is the opposite. It's not that they're doing it wrong, but they want to learn more of the hardware. This is more about the hardware. Okay? In our case, we're more about the software, because we're not developing the hardware, we're using it. So at the end of this course, the students should be able to develop, design your own protocol, make use of the socket library, understand all the different protocols and the different layers, how they interoperate, how the products relate to these protocols, and how they work together. Okay. Here are the objectives. In short, this course is all about the what, the why, and the how of networking protocols. So we're going to be introduced to lots and lots of jargon, okay? And you say DHCP, dynamic host configuration protocol. There's so many. Say TCP, transmission control protocol, UDP, user diagram protocol. You will start learning them, but hopefully it's not going to be a pain. We're going to learn them as we use them, okay? This course will also allow us to be exposed to using network analysis tools. For instance, through using your machine, how do you know what is your IP address, for instance, to which subnetwork are you connected to, and what is your first hop router, and how far is this computer from MIT? Let us, you can have a look at that later on, okay? I need to check if my internet is working. Let me just check. So for instance, hopefully it's big enough. ipconfig/all. You'll be doing this, when testing the assignments. There are some network tools that are essential in developing codes and understanding how your computer is connected. And it's also very useful for debugging. So for instance, it's telling me here that, oh, my computer's name is IT09-2024. This is a host name that is assigned. It's a human readable name. But this computer can also be referred to by using its IP address. It's a number. And there are two IP addresses. You'll find that we've got IPv4. Let's find that one. IPv4. So this computer's number. Maybe it's good to build on some of this knowledge on the board, so hopefully combine everything together. We've got 2 hours, so let's try to make use of the most of it. So if you have a computer, for instance,